All right, welcome back to another video. Today I'm going to be talking about a different text editor that I like to use. I know a lot of people typically use VS Code or Codium, depending on which version you want to use. It's kind of like the standard for regular code or text editors that people just gravitate towards that, or you'll use like Vim or NeoVim or something else. But I wanted to talk about one that I just started using recently, and it's called Zed. The Zed editor is over here. I can show you their website real quick. Basically, this is a next-gen code editor designed for high-performance collaboration with humans and AI. It does have an AI feature that I like to use. It is available on macOS, Linux, and soon for Windows. So it's not on Windows just yet, but it will be coming. The fact that it's available for Linux before it's available for Windows, like, I already like this platform even better. It is really fast, intelligent, yes, with the different LLMs options and stuff that you can add, which I'll show you here in a second. And they have a collaborative mode for teams to work together. We can actually see the other people in the system as well. So here it's just showing that Zed works. You're able to get working really quickly. They have a ton of different themes that you can install as well. Some of the features here you can see it has native Git support, edit prediction, friendly terminal and task runner, interactive programming, remote development. It has all the normal options that you would see in an editor like this, like a competitor of like, you know, VS Code or Codium. So what I really like about it is it's just a little bit more simplistic in my use case. Code has so many different options. I like the way everything's laid out here. So I can give you a quick tour of the way Zed editors work. You have your directory here, and the next one is the Git panel. I like the way they track their Git changes. It's very intuitive. It has stage all, and you can fetch and have the option to push, pull, and everything there. And then you can commit your tracked changes there. Whereas on, you know, VS Code, if you go to Git, it's just not intuitive. It just has a bunch of icons. So if you're new to this, you kind of have to hover over each one of these and see which one does what. And like looking at all like the changes and everything, it's not as intuitive as what they have over here. I know there's different ways of configuring this to make it different, but this is how it is out of the box. So I don't think it's like the best implementation of that, where I think they do a really good job over here. Then you also have the collaborative mode. I mean, you do have to sign in through your GitHub credentials to get that. And then you have your language servers and any project diagnostics. So it does have a bunch of different language servers that you can choose. Right now I'm in a NixOS configuration, but already picked up on Nil and NixD. And it's using the Nix language over here as far as like the syntax and everything for the coloring. It picks up on those things pretty nicely. And if you go up here, you can go into your settings. Everything is in JSON files for all the settings. I do like the ability to change the key bindings. I haven't really messed with this too much, but it does have like a full-blown option to change all of your different key bindings in a nice, you know, easy way. And then you also have your project settings and your default key bindings that you can see there. You can select your theme, so you can see all the themes that I have installed already. But you can install more themes in the extensions manager as well. You can switch the theme quickly and easily. You'd have to go to extensions, find your theme, and enable it or disable it based on what you want. So everything's just done through extensions on VS Code. I like the way they do it here. It's separate from the extensions. But if I go to extensions, everything's laid out here. I think it's laid out well. You can go to languages, see all the languages that show what's installed on your system. I like the way everything's laid out. It's more intuitive than other editors have used in the past. You can install through CLI, which it does by default when you get it installed already. And then if we go to like file, you can open new folder, which is like, you see all of these settings are a little bit more simplistic and intuitive. If I go to file over here, there's a lot more going on. It just seems like so much more busy. And this is kind of like just simplified. And I can click here and open different projects that I have opened already very easily. I can open on a new window by doing control enter, or on this window by just hitting enter. You can see the different branches that you can select and switch branches from there. They do have their own subscription that you can use if you want to. I no longer have the actual subscription. I just did the trial version to try it out and see what it was like. They use Claude and a bunch of different AI options, but I found that using their option to use Claude Code made it easier to have one subscription and just add it into my editor here. I can do a new Claude Code thread and then use my AI agent here. You can accept edits, like the different options you would with most it's just easier to enable all these things. So if I go into settings, you can see I have the Cloud Code options, and I can also enable any other option here and enable my MCP servers, add custom servers. They do have an extension store for MPC servers over here, so you can add those as you see fit. And then like the Zed Pro, like I said, option you have over here that you can use, and then you can add a key for, you know, your Claude key if you want to. They have Deep Sync. They have pretty much all of them, and they're adding new ones even since I've started using it. They have pretty much all of the different options when it comes to the AI side of things, which is nice. They make it simpler to enable and use than other ones that I've used in the past. I just wanted to share the overall experience I've been having with Zed. It's been really good. They have a ton of different themes. So if you want to theme your Zed browser, you can see here they have a ton. You can search for different ones. You can customize these if you want to. Some of these are already included in the actual editor, so you can just go through the extensions option, or you can download these straight from here and then add them into your editor as well. If you have been enjoying my content, please consider liking and subscribing or joining my membership, or you can also, you know, support me on my Patreon, which I can put in the description below, so you can get more videos like this. Once I have enough members, I'll be doing some member only live streams and going through my config and updating it. If you want to join that, you can. Let me know what you guys, you know, think about the Zed editor in the comments below, what editor you, like, you use by choice, if you are using like VS Code or whatever you are using currently. You know, let me know in the comments below, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace.